that you put at the top of the statement? Company name would be a really good idea. Be sure and do that. Then what do you put? Statement of cash flow would be a really good idea, don't you think? And then what? For a year ended, right? If you don't put for a year ended, you just put a date, I'll mark something off. Okay, right? You know that, okay? Obviously, it's just for a year. Okay, and then what are the three sections? First one we're gonna list is? Operations. Go down about half the page, list what? Industry, go down another quarter page, then what? Financing, okay? Then you go down to the bottom, you put what? Changing cash. Then what? Beginning cash. At the beginning cash, the changing cash, what do you get? Ending cash. Where do you get beginning and ending cash? In the balance sheet, right? They're there. How do you get the changing cash? Subtract the beginning from the ending. Write it down, okay? Get the answer before you start, get your statement all set up, and then you just plug everything where it goes, okay? What goes under financing? Where does the financing come from? Non-current liabilities, long-term debt, right? That's where you get your financing. But before you get that, where do you get it from? Equity holdings, right? So it's contributed capital, right?
It is.
Okay, you also put dividends in there because that's transactions with the owners, right? You don't put net income in there because that goes up under operations, right? But everything else in equity goes down in there, right? And everything in debt, long-term debt, goes down in there too. That's financing, isn't it? Show both the increases and decreases, true? Why? Because they're big. Right? Big items, big transactions, and there aren't very many of them. So you show them both, don't you? Okay, what goes in investing? What does a company invest in? Non-current assets, land, building, equipment, other companies, you know, all that stuff, right? All the things they buy, okay? You show both the increases and decreases there? Yes. Do you show anything else in there? No. Right? That's what they invest in. Yes, sir.
Do you have to say, like, increase, or can you just put the number?
You don't need to say increase or decrease. You say what it was.
Okay.
Dividends paid.
Yeah.
Long-term debt issued. Long-term debt paid back, you know, whatever it is, bonds or mortgages or whatever. And the same thing with the assets, land purchased, land sold, whatever it is, okay? The only place you show the changes is where? Increase or decrease change. That's up under what? Operations. What goes under operations? The operating stuff. Revenues less expenses, you don't show those, but what do you show? Net income or net loss, because that's what you got from operations. No kidding, right? Okay, and then what do you add to that? Any non-cash items like depreciation expense, amortization expense if you had it, sometimes unearned revenue, you don't have to pass, right? But there's others, right? So any non-cash items in the income statement, guess what, it goes there. Then what else? Any gain or loss on non-current assets that are down under investing, or really also on debt, right? Remember the gains and losses on retiring bonds, right? If you did that, I won't do that to you. But if you have that, that has to go as an adjustment to operations too. So we'll do that again, and that was fuzzy from last time, I'm sure. Okay, and that's one of the tougher things. Okay, so you got to put those types of things up there. Then what else hits operations? Current assets and current liabilities. Why do you have current assets? To run your operations. Why do you have current liabilities? To run your operations. And there is where you show the change, just the change. You don't show increase and decrease because there's millions of transactions in a big company, right? I mean, I'll apple goes up and put it down. What for? Now, by the way, that's the indirect method. What would the direct method do? It'd add all them up, put them down. It'd add up all the debits to accounts receivable and all the credits to accounts receivable and show them separately. Right? Cash receipts from customers and sales. You know, it's fine. Okay? We're not going to have to do that. We'll just do the indirect. And by the way, it's not real hard. Could you find out how much cash came in from customers or how much cash went out to vendors? Pretty easy. The cash that came in from customers is the credit to accounts receivable for the year, you guys. And they say that's hard. No, it's not. We know what it is. Okay. For the expenses, right, what's that going to be? They're all the credits, the cash, right? That were for expenses. It's all payment vendors. Forget Benny. All right, so let's give this a shot. Let's do this company. If I can get this thing to work somewhere. We can kill that middle light. It makes it a little brighter, I think, for you guys. As long as it's not hot, let's leave the blinds open. Natural light. Yeah, there you go. Thank you, sir. All right, so let's do the other one. We did Eaton Company, and we've got a class next time. Well, what are we going to do next time anyway? These are pretty hard chapters. I thought it might be kind of nice. Also, it's kind of nice at the end. You're cranking for everything else. It's not a day off, right? But we can really get solid. That investments chapter, and this cash flow chapter. So Friday, we're going to do that, right? And then Friday, I guess, if you want, we'll do a review session. If some of you can make it, free to whenever, okay? And get you ready for the quiz. And then after the quiz, which is Monday, I think, right? What are we doing? 2 days on chapter 13, right? We're not going to have a quiz on that. We'll do 2 days on that. We'll talk about it, okay? What's going on with financial analysis. And then what? Test Friday.
Wednesday.
So we got more. We got time to get ready for the test. Like a day off. Get ready for the test or something. So you got some room, right? Got some room. I can't remember what days or something like that. Okay. All right. And then we got a whole bunch of time. We got a whole week to get ready for the final. You're welcome. That's good, isn't it? I mean, we cranked through this stuff, but you know what happens during that week anyway. I realized real early in my teaching career, everybody checks out there and getting ready for all their finals anyway. So in this case, you're going to get ready for final, okay? And what we'll do is we'll crank through all the exams, right? Oh, and I don't think I scheduled any review sessions for the final yet, did I? We'll do them, right? We'll set some up. So in class, we'll study for the final, right? Work on things from the beginning of the course. You're going to really enjoy going back and doing the test on chapters 1 through 4. You're not going to believe how easy it is. And that is 1/3 of the final because that was 1/3 of the class, right? It's comprehensive. It's all the way through. You've got to learn that stuff. You're going to get a lot of points for that, okay? And then the second test, a little tougher, right? And this one a little tougher, but you know, at least they're a little more reasonable, okay? So anyway, that's how it's going to work. So what do we write down first? Company name, what is it, Foxborough Company? Spell it out. And of course, you spell it out properly. Okay, statement of cash flows or cash flow statement, right, guys? I am recording, can I? Okay, and for the year ended, and the date, what's the date on this thing? Year two, whatever that means. Okay, but anyway, you know, it'd be something. Okay? Everybody knows that year end doesn't have to be December 31st, even though we seem to always use them in principles. December 31st can be any date here. All right, anyway, so we've got this information. It's from the balance sheet, right? But they're not in a logical order. They're just debits and credits. And so I guess I have to realize that accumulated depreciation really is a contra asset. And otherwise, so what? Right? Not a big deal. And then down, so we got to know what the balances are. So we could prepare a balance sheet from that, couldn't we? You don't have to. We didn't ask for it. We'll just take the information. Equipment that cost $30,000, which there was accumulated depreciation, 10 was sold during the year for 26. Okay, fine. Do you have a gain or loss on that thing? What's this book value? 30 less 10 is 20. You sold it for 26. What do you have? Gain of 6. What would you have on your income statement? A 6 gain. Oh, they gave us the income statement. And there it is. Look at that. There's a gain on the sale of equipment on the income statement. Everybody see it there? Everybody has one of these in front of them by now, right?
Which one are you on?
Otherwise, I guess 1612. Second one. Yeah, up at the top. See the income statement? On that page. Yeah. See it?
Yeah.
Okay, 6,000 there for gain on sale of equipment. Okay. Yeah, all right, fine. Cash dividends are 33 declared paid, and that's all the information we have, so I guess everything else is, you know, if they issued debt or paid off debt or something, or they issued stock or retired stock. It must have just been one transaction, because they didn't give us anything else out. Okay, anyway, so let's set up our statement. We got this to start with. What do you want to do first? Operations. And I'm going to do it a little different this time. I'm just going to go through every account in order, just to show you that we can do it any order we want. Don't panic if you don't know what to do first. You're not remembering this, right? What for? Right? It just makes sense, doesn't it? Okay, I don't know what you have to remember here. They call it operations, but it's operations. They call it investing, but it's investing. They call it financing, but it's financing. Huh? That's memory, right? It's just common sense. If you get out about half the page and write down what? Investing. They're upside down, aren't they? Okay. And financing activities, right? Okay, cash flow from financing. Okay, good. And then we're going to have total down at the bottom, which is going to be the increase or decrease in cash. What happened to cash? Looks like it went down by 8. By the way, you guys do know cash could go up, right? That's fine. Okay, joke. All right? Anyway, so both of these happen to be down. Okay, so anyway, so we got a decrease in cash. Write it down. How much was it? 8,000? Please put brackets around it. Of course. When I add up these three sections, operations, investing, and financing, what's going to add up to? Decrease in cash. It's got to be, right? What was the beginning cash? What was the ending cash? I don't know. It might be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points already. No kidding. Okay? How could you miss those? Impossible. All right, anyway, so you got it, huh? Put a check mark next to cash, okay? Don't write it down again, or this will not total up to the change in cash. We're writing and changing every balance sheet account once and only once. Guess what it'll all add up to? Seeing as the balance sheet balances, because debits equal credits. If you write down every account except for cash, what's it all going to add up to? The change in all of them except for cash. It's going to add up to the change in cash, of course. This, you can't screw this up, huh? Right? It's impossible. Okay? All right. So let's just go through an order, huh? Where does accounts receivable go? What kind of account is it? Current asset. Where do they go?
Operations.
Leave yourself some room for net income and gains and losses and depreciation and amortization. Leave yourself some room. So go down, you know, I don't know, a third of the way or something in that section. And write down what? Current assets, maybe? Is it increase or decrease in accounts receivable? Went up, didn't it? And of course you'd write out increase in real life. You wouldn't use arrows, but you know, whatever. You can use an arrow for me, I don't care. Increase in accounts receivable. Please, when you go to work, don't draw arrows on financial statements. It's just nuts. Okay. Anyway, so what's that? 70,000? Nobody's going to be preparing financial statements by hand because we don't anyway. It's computers. Right?
So when we're writing it on the test, do we have to put current asset and do we also?
Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah. It'll help you remember what you're doing. I'd write current asset and current liability. Let me take this split second. Right? I would. That way it gets me organized. Put them where they go. Right? Why not? Okay. Try to put them in the right order. I won't take off points for not having the right order because I know you're under pressure and you're cranking on it, right? Geez, I didn't leave enough room. Yeah, that kind of thing. Just write it right down. Get it in the right section, though. If you put that increase in accounts receivable under investing or financing, wrong. Okay? And that'll screw up your totals, too. Wrong. Got it? Two totals. Okay? All right, anyway. So now we can check out accounts receivable, can't we? That's all we have to do, just to change it. Inventory? What's that? Current asset, more or less? More, okay? Increase in inventory. Oh, this is too easy. How much is that? 48? Oh, wait a minute. Do I have more or less cash? Wait a minute. That was debit accounts receivable. What would it be? Credit cash. Oh, wow. How many noticed they did it wrong? A couple. Why didn't you say something? I'm your boss. You're just going to let me screw up? Go on with life? Then I'll get done and the statement won't tell it. I'll be mad at you. Right? So, didn't you realize that? Well, yeah. I thought I was probably wrong, not you. Don't do that. Stick your neck out there. Right? If you're wrong, it gives them something to laugh at you about. And they can also teach you. Right? Be courageous. Right? Screw up. I think I screwed up something already the other day with the new dean. I think he's going to be really pissed at me. What's he going to do to me? Maybe I won't have to do as much work. Right? I mean, yeah. If he gets mad at me about something I did, then I just won't do that anymore, okay? I say, no, please. Please, tell me next time. You dumb shit. Yeah, but anyway, I recorded that. Okay, anyway, now I'm calling myself a dumb shit. Okay. Anyway, oh well. So, we got more inventory, we must have less cash, right? Because we bought the inventory. We have more accounts receivable, we have less cash because we sold stuff and didn't collect it. Right, guys? And what I mean is less cash compared to what net income's going to be. That's all we're doing. Okay? All right. Because we might not have paid for the inventory yet. It might be an accounts payable. But we're going to take care of accounts payable too, aren't we? That'll be fine. Okay? We pretend everything was for cash. Prepaid. What happened to prepaid? Oh, by the way, what kind of account is prepaid? Current asset. Almost. It isn't always, by the way. What if the prepaid is going to be used in more than a year? It's a non-current asset. And then you have to decide what you're going to do with it. Probably as well, together with the other prepaid. Yeah. Okay, anyway. So it went down, did it? By 9? What'd you pay it with? You didn't pay it. It wasn't a bill. You used it up. If you used it up and didn't replace it, when you used it up, you have an expense in your income statement, right? You didn't use any cash. That's what really happened. If you don't follow that stuff, don't worry about it. Just pretend what? Everything was for cash. I bought the current assets for cash, right? I sold the current assets for cash. It'll work fine. Okay? Just, you'll get it right on the statement. Okay, so decrease in prepaids, what do you want to do with that? No bracket, right? I didn't replace it. So I have more cash than if I had, what you can think about it. All right, check that one off. And loan to Harker Company, if you're loaning to another company, you think it's short term? I doubt it. I even think that was a long term. Okay? And loan to another company, come on. And plant and equipment, certainly non-current. So, let's do it. Loan to Harker. If it's non-current, where does it go? Oh, by the way, both those things are non-current, where do they go? Investing, absolutely. Right, guys? This is easy, isn't it? Okay? So, this is not part of the statement. We're just doing a worksheet over here, right? Okay? So, what happened to loan to Parker? Parker, I'm sorry. It went from nothing to 40, and it doesn't say anything about it. What must they have done? I guess they loaned them money, right? Debit what? Loan to Harker Company, notes receivable, probably, right? And you loan a company money, or it's a note, but they can call it loan if they want, I don't care. Notes receivable, right? Debit for 40, and credit what? Cash. Sure, so that's cash going out, isn't it? And again, where does it go? It's an investment. We're probably getting interest on it, I hope so, right? Okay, so loan to Harker. Or loan to another company, or whatever, you call it whatever you want. Investment in a loan, I guess. Okay, that's fine.
Did you say, like, notes receivable?
Yeah, I'd be fine with that. If you realize the note receivable, yeah. Don't say increase or decrease in notes receivable. Say loaned, note receivable, right? Because you loan money out, right? So loan to Harker, $40,000. Do I have more or less cash if I gave them the money? Right? Debit, notes receivable, and credit. Cash, right? Good. Put a check mark on it. I assume there were no payments because they didn't give me any information beyond that, right? What if I loaned them 100 and they paid back 60? I'd show 100 going out and 60 coming back in, two separate lines. Everybody good? This is not a big deal, is it? Why do I think we need to really pound on this chapter? Because you can know it, understand it, and not be able to do it. What do I have to get you guys to do here? Do some, right? Make sure you just do this in your sleep. And that quiz is going to be easy. On the test, a quarter of the test is going to be easy. Got it? And on the final, I don't know what the final is. 114. Okay? Got it, guys? So, just for doing one problem. All right, and then for plant and equipment, what account is going to go with plant and equipment? You know this. I know you do. What account has to go with? Accumulated depreciation, right? Please don't put accumulated depreciation down into liabilities just because it's down there with the credits, because it's a credit. I know you guys know that it's not a liability, right? Let yourself think, okay? How many times have I said that? I tell myself that constantly, too, by the way. Why didn't you think about it before you did it? Okay, plant and equipment, is that what they call it? Okay, good. You know, property, plant, equipment, land, building, equipment, okay? Accumulated depreciation, those go together, don't they? I already know there's a transaction. We read it down at the bottom. What is it? They sold something, didn't they? Something that cost what? $30,000. So it's plant and equipment, right? It's credited for the $30,000. You guys agree with that? 30 comes out of there. Everybody agree with that? Okay, we already knew it. And then let's see, accumulated depreciation was 10. What do you bet 10 comes out of there? True, guys? Down at the bottom, equipment that had cost 30, I wish there was accumulated depreciation of 10, was sold during the year for 26. Got it? They told you. Otherwise, I wouldn't know, right? They have to give me some information, okay? By the way, if they didn't tell me about that and they gave me how much I bought and they gave me how much my depreciation expense was, I could have figured it out, especially if I had the gain or loss on the thing. On the income statement, I could see that gain. If you happen to see it, I know I have a gain. If you don't happen to see it, it is going to be a gain, right? Well, you know it is. Gain on sale. Now, I know it because I saw it on the income statement, but if I didn't see it, what do I know? If I didn't have that yet, what do I know? I got cash at how much, you guys? $26,000. What was the book value of the asset? $20,000. You guys know what book value means now, don't you? When you go to work and somebody says the book value of this asset is, and we are selling it for, you're going to know whether it's a gain or loss, aren't you? And that's valuable. And especially if you've only had this one accounting class, and maybe 102, some of you are only doing this one, probably, right? If you're arts administration or something, you only do one, right? But if you do just these two classes and you graduate and you know what book value means and you know what that you'd have a gain or a loss on a transaction, they're going to be impressed with you. Me? Really? What was your major again? Did you do learn something in the classes that weren't in your major? That's unbelievable. What's wrong with you? Right? So maybe to know who the philosophers are, it might be kind of cool. What are they talking about? Right? I talk about Plato all the time. I know Plato was really cool. Plato had the right idea. Nobody should be a leader who wants to be. Because it's such a god-awful job. Don't you think it'd be a god-awful job to be president? Nobody really would want to be president and do it. Who'd want to run for it? Who in their right mind? There's something wrong with these people that they want to be president, right? Nobody should be a leader unless somebody forces them to. That was his view. The Republic, right? Ridiculous. So he thought that it would only be people who were really good at doing a whole bunch of things and really didn't want to do it, and because of their, you know, dedication to society, you could force them to do it for a little while, and then they wouldn't have to anymore. So the idea of real short terms, right, way back there, right? You don't connect anything you're learning to now, do you? That'd be dumb, wouldn't it? History is just about the past. Philosophy is just old philosophers that have been dead for a thousand years or whatever, hundreds of years. That's what it's about, right? You know, let's not learn anything from anybody else that was ever here on Earth. That'd be dumb. I think as soon as our generation is gone, your generation is gone, we should not have cell phones anymore so they can invent things again. Don't you think? Let's quit using automobiles so somebody can invent it again. That's mostly what we do in education, isn't it? Reinvent the same thing we did. You know what's really cool about business is you can do that. You can even write books about it. You can write books about how to run a company. What you really should do, I'm sure these people that write them do that. They go find ones that were written 100 years ago and then they rewrite it in current terms but say exactly the same thing. And then they make a whole bunch of money selling the book to new people that haven't read the old book, right? Don't know it exists, and they created something brand new. You can do that with everything, with managing people, with making products. Just recreate the wheel, right? It's a different wheel, but just recreate the wheel. This is kind of the same stuff, really. Okay, so what do we do here, guys? That's 20, isn't it? Everybody agree? Put that transaction over here on this financial statement, right, on the cash flow statement. What happened? I think we got cash of 26,000. How many of you guys believe that? Where does it go? What is this thing? Plant and equipment. It's a long-term asset. It goes under investing. Okay? Sale of equipment. You guys like that? How much was it? 26,000. Now, if I put that 26,000 down and there's only a 20 change in the accounts, you see it's only 20? It's a credit of 20 to equipment, a debit to accumulated depreciation, the net is 20. What else have I got to do? I've got to pick up the 6 gain, don't I? Because the gain was included in net income and I don't want to count it twice. That's all. Because it's in the 26, isn't it? So I'm going to subtract the gain on sale. Does everybody see, this is tougher stuff, isn't it? Does everybody see that 26 less 6 is 20? It's the change, right? That's all we did. Okay, what else do we know? They told us what the depreciation, they didn't. They did not tell us what the depreciation is, did they? Oh, and they didn't tell us what they bought either. What do we know, though? I think we know the beginning and ending balances. We always will. What plant and equipment started at 500,000, did it? And it ended how much? What's the minimum amount we must have bought? Looks like 120 to me, but we sold 30, so what did you buy? 150. Did I do the numbers right? I see concerned looks. Is that right? You know, you started with 500 and 620, you bought at least 120. If you sold 30, you bought 150, right? Nothing to it. So what would that be? Debit plant and equipment, right? And credit what? That's for the 150, was it? Credit what, guys? We pretend everything was for cash. In real life, we don't really. What we do is at the bottom of the statement, we show the non-cash transactions. If it was debit, plant and equipment, and credit, mortgage, payable, we'd write it down at the bottom of the statement. But for now, we just pretend it was for cash. We don't know what it was for anyway. Right? Okay? Got it? Okay. So what do you want to do with this one? Cash went out. It's for plant and equipment, which is a what? non-current asset, investing, purchase. You like this? This is plant equipment. I don't know if it's building, land, whatever, okay, equipment. And that's cash going out. It's a credit to cash, right? Debits to cash or cash coming in? Credits to cash or cash going out? Huh? Right? So you just use it. You know, that's what I say. If you know all the journalicus, you got it made, don't you? Can't miss this stuff. What other thing? What do we got? I can check out plant equipment, but I can't do accumulated depreciation yet, can I? What happened? What did I start at with accumulated depreciation? 130? What did it end up at? What's the minimum amount depreciation expense has got to be? 35. Except I took 10 out. So what is it? I think it's 45. Don't you guys? That's it. I think it's debit depreciation expense, because that's how we record depreciation, right? Can't talk today. Okay? And credit what? Accumulated depreciation. Ta-da. That one has no cash in it, but what's the deal? My income is $45,000 less, right, than the cash flow. How do I know that? Because I debited depreciation expense, right? And credit accumulated depreciation. When does the cash go out for buildings and equipment? Either when you buy them or when you pay off the debt. Not when you depreciate it. It's a non-cash expense, isn't it? By the way, are there other non-cash expenses? Of course. I won't give you any more, right? Amortization of patents, right? Amortization of leasehold improvements, unearned revenue being earned, right? If it was non-current, prepaids being used up if they were non-current. I mean, it gets a little more complicated. Okay, so big deal. Well, what I'm going to do then is I'm going to add the depreciation, okay? So let's add back the depreciation. And this is the expense, you guys. I am not adding back the 165 ending balance in accumulated depreciation. Now, students do that, like, what are you doing? Right? What's on the income statement? The 45,000 depreciation expense. What are we adding back? The 45,000 depreciation expense. Everybody good? We got it? Oh, that's deduct gain on sale. You can say deduct if you want to, right? But put brackets around it. I know you're deducting it, obviously. Okay? All right. Now I can check off accumulated depreciation category. And I think we've done all the assets. So let's go down and let's do the current liability account. Oh, accounts payable. What kind of account is it? Current liability. Let's do the current liabilities. Where do they go? Part of operations, aren't they? So let's do current liabilities. If I have more of a current liability, I borrowed money. If I have less of a current liability, I paid it off. Pretty straightforward. What happened to accounts payable? Went up by 50? Is that right? You guys aren't careful at all. What do you think? I did not pay some bills. I have more cash than if I had. That's it. Okay? So it's more cash, isn't it? Okay? Debit cash, credit accounts payable effectively. What happened to accrued liabilities, though? Went down, didn't it? And of course, there could be a lot of current assets and current liabilities. You have to do them all. Okay? Accrued liabilities, what happened? It went down by 8. What'd you pay it with? Cash. Everybody got it? Now you can check off that one. Don't you love the current ones? Nice and easy. Bonds payable. What happened to bonds payable? It went up by 90, did it? And they didn't say anything. Could they have borrowed 200 and paid back 110 and had it go up by 90? Yes, and if they had, you'd show them both. One would be I have more cash from borrowing money, and the other would be I have less cash from paying it back. And I'd show both. Why? This is financing activity. These are big transactions, right? So they didn't say anything, so what do we think happened? It looks like they just borrowed 90,000, okay? So what would you say? Where does it go? Non-current liability, where does it go, guys? Financing, and we call this issue bonds payable. You guys know about issuing bonds payable because we did bonds payable. And you know the journal entry is debit, cash, and credit bonds payable. By the way, in real life, would there be a discount or a premium? Yes. Would you have to consider that? Sure, the contra account would go with, right? Contra account, it's a discount. A dividend account, if it's a premium, it'd go with a long-term debt that's sold, right? Just the cash that was received. How much is that? 90,000. So they're trying to keep it a little simpler for you. That's nice. Okay. So now we've done bonds payable. Okay. Deferred income tax. Now, on deferred income tax, this one's going to be kind of funny. Last time, I had to put it under financing because it's down there with a long-term debt. And I'll live with it if you do that. You could put under financing that I borrowed, it went up by four, I borrowed $4,000 from the federal government on a long-term basis. People don't really use that, usually do that. Where do they put it? The author's showing the answer, under operations. And here's why. The tax expense on the net income is $4,000 more than the cash that went out. Let me show you how that works. Put down a little bit here, that's some room. Okay, so what would the journal entry have been for deferred income tax? It looks to me like they must have credited deferred income tax payable by how much? It was 80, now it's 84, you guys. 4,000. What do you think they debited income tax expense for? Take a look at the income statement. What did they debit income tax expense for? What's income taxes say? Income statement, less income tax. That's income tax expense, isn't it? Yeah. And these are all revenues and expenses, guys. It's less, of course, it's an expense. 27,000? Oh. How much tax payable currently was there? This is current income tax payable versus deferred. Deferred is long-term liability. Current is what I'm going to pay this year. What do you think I'm paying this year? 23. Debits have to equal credits, don't they? And then when they paid it, what would their entry have been? Debit tax payable. Because we don't pay the deferred. That's the whole idea. It's deferred to the future, isn't it? That's from, I used accelerated depreciation, right, on my tax return. Big expense, right? Use straight line on my financial statements, a little expense, right? So my tax expense on the income statement is more than on my tax return, right? Because I have less depreciation on my tax return. Got it? There's one example, okay? So it's timing differences, deferred income tax. We read about it, we looked at it, I asked you a really simple question on a quiz, right? So we're trying to get a little deeper into it now, a little bit, okay? So tax payable, if we paid it all, would have been debit 23, right? And what do you credit when you pay off your bills? Cash. So that one's gone, right? And what we've got is debit tax expense, right? And credit deferred income tax, payable and credit cash when we're done with the deal for the year. Okay, so what do you want to do? You want to take this deferred income tax payable and say, under operations, increase deferred income tax payable. I have 4,000 more cash because I borrowed the money from the federal government this year. Right? Got it? My tax expense is too high from a cash standpoint. By $4,000. Check out that one. Common stock. What happened to common stock? Didn't say anything, so they didn't retire any. They didn't buy back any treasury stock. Oh, besides they have a treasury stock account, which of course we'd have to use, right, guys? And you wouldn't just have common stock, you'd have additional paid-in capital, wouldn't you? So you'd have to group all those together. I won't do that to you either. I'll keep it simple like this, okay? They're all together. Common stock includes all the paid-in capital, okay? So what happened? It went up by 60. What do you think happened? Maybe they issued stock. Where does equity go? Other than net income, where does equity? Because net income needs to go up under operations, right? Revenue less expenses from operating your business. Where do all the transactions with the owners go? Under financing, right? This was a source of financing. What did we do? I think we issued common stock. Don't you? Issued common stock. How much did we issue? 60,000, was it? Good. All right, check that off. And all we have left is retained earnings. So let's do retained earnings, okay? What's retained earnings going to look like? What do I know about retained earnings? What's beginning retained earnings? 90? What's ending? Now, they told me what the dividends are, and they told me what the net income was, but could I have told you either one of those and not the other one? Uh-huh. What if I gave you the dividends? What were they? 33,000? What are you going to do? Debit retained earnings for the dividends, right, guys? That's the beginning. That's ending. That's a dividend. How long have we been working with this stuff? What did I do? Second day of class or first? Probably second. Maybe the first. I don't know. Might have been. We've been doing this a long time, haven't we? You guys know this. Just let yourself use it. Beginning, ending. Well, what if I had not given you net income, could you tell me what that net income has to be? Well, yeah. 90 less 33 is how much? 57. So now I got up to 120. What must net income be? 63. It's a miracle. Now, if you have an income statement, you've got the 63 anyway, don't you? So what if I gave you these three numbers and I didn't give you that one? So what? I can get it, right? So relax when you do this stuff. By the way, if you go back, when you go back and look at chapters 1 through 4, tests and quizzes, I did that to you all the time. I gave you beginning balance, ending balance, either the debit or the credit, and asked for the other one. You understand what's going on, right? Nothing to it. You're not debit or credit for it. If I know any three of those four, I can solve the other one, because I'm a brilliant mathematician, right? Yeah, tough. Okay? I can add and subtract. Pretty good. Okay, well, with the calculator. All right, so where do we want to put that stuff, you guys? I think net income needs to go on, right? I'm explaining the change in retained earnings of 30. I'm going to put the net income on, and I'm going to put the dividend on, right? Where do they go? Where does the net income go? That's from operating my company. Net income. How much was it? 63? Okay, now that's not the change in retained earnings. The change in retained earnings is 30. What else do I need? 33 going out. Where does it go? It was a transaction with the owners. I gave them the cash, right? It's going to be debit retained earnings credit cash. Or maybe debit retained earnings and credit dividends payable, and then later pay it, debit dividends payable and credit cash. There's no dividends payable here, so I know they paid it. Right, guys? If there's no beginning balance in dividends payable and no ending balance in dividends payable, and they have a dividend, what must they have done? They paid the dividend, otherwise there'd be dividends payable. Got it? Of course that's true. Okay? So here's the deal. You get better and better at this, further into it. You become an accounting major, finance and accounting major. As you go forward, you're going to see what happened to the company when you look at their financials. You're going to know what happened without talking to people about what happened. I told you about being in Ostrom Mushroom Farms and a farm manager who was probably in his mid-40s, and I thought he was really old because I was 23 or 24, right? After a meeting, he pulled me aside and he says, Keith, you've only been here for a month. How can you know this much about the company? You know what my response was? I read the financial statement. I had to prepare them before I could read it because they hadn't done them for months. I mean, just frankly doing financials, right? Trying to figure out where they were at, what was going on, because they were out of cash because they were going bankrupt. And when you fix it, I got the help. It's really fun. It's cool. A little stressful, but really fun. Right? I didn't make any of the decisions, trust me, to fix the company. I just analyzed everything for people who really knew what they were doing. They hired a marketing manager who had been with Nally's Potato Chips, which Lay's ended up buying out. You know, anyway, he's been a marketing manager. You know, kidding. Boy, did he understand it. Wow. And finance and stuff. So, anyway, he found some ways to really make money. And I analyzed them all for him and recorded all the stuff way back then. But anyway, so this farm manager says, how could you know so much about this company? You're just a kid. You've only been here for a little while. And so I read the financials and then you guys told me. I thought we were just having beers and chat. I'd already worked for Arthur Anderson for a while. Right? My second job. Yeah. I had to ask a question. That was an honor. I want to know everything about everything. You guys, I knew how to grow mushrooms. I couldn't have grown them if my life depended on it. It's an art, right? Science and an art sort of combined. I couldn't grow a mushroom. Are you kidding me? Can you guys make mushrooms grow? Go out there in the woods and make mushrooms grow. Good luck. These mycologists can make mushrooms grow in test tubes, right? And then in horseshit. I'm not kidding, in beds, right? You aren't eating the horseshit when you eat the mushrooms. They come up through a layer of dirt or peat moss on top, right? But the mycelium grows in the horse lips, right? Okay, it's all sterilized before they put it in there. Don't quit eating mushrooms. They're good for you. Okay, and they're good. All right, anyway. So where do we put these? We got the income here, and what else do we need? The dividend. Where does it go? Financing. Dividends paid. Actually, they only need to be declared, but we know they were paid too, so you can say paid. All right, 33,000. That's debit retained earnings and credit cash. Are we done? Except I didn't leave myself any room again, of course. Okay, so what do we have now? Totals to do, and we're done. Right? I can manage to use all the time even if I don't have anything to do. It's amazing. Skill I've developed over the years. So, What are they anyway? What's 63 plus 45 less 6 plus 4? What do you get? How much was it? Positive. So we have 106,000 came from operations. Nice. Okay, and then, whoops, that's I don't want that total. Why did I do that? I want it down here. Is that 106?
No.
I'm sorry. We don't have to do that total. You can if you want, but you don't have to.
39,000.
Okay. So, way to go. How much was the, this was 4,000? Is that the only one I erased, I hope? Okay, increase in dividends payable. All right, and then, so what's this going to be called? Total cash flow from what? Operations. Good? All right. 39,000. And that's less than the income, isn't it? But you can see why, huh? What changed? So if your client's asking you, the company's asking, your boss is asking you, how can we have less cash? Right? You know, how'd this happen? Why do we have a decrease in cash with 63,000 net income? You can see, well, from operations, it's only 39,000. Why did that happen? Because we did what? We bought a bunch of inventory and built the receivables a lot. Right? Got the idea? What was the receivables again? Increase in how much? I erased part of it. 70, wasn't it? 70. Sorry. Okay, got it? That's the two things that did me in, huh? What helped me? I increased accounts payable. Right? You can see it there. Okay, on investing, what do we have? 164. Now that happened to us. Oh, we loaned money to a company and then we bought a whole bunch of books. Right? That's it? Okay. What about financing? 117 positive. How'd that happen? Well, we borrowed 90,000, stockholders invested 60,000, but we paid dividends of 33. It's right in front of you. Okay? Kind of nice. Okay? Now, you want to, when you're done there, what should you do? Add the 39, right? Plus the 164, plus the 117, right? So 39 less 164 plus 117, is that negative 8? I sure hope so, right? Make sure it is, of course. Okay, otherwise you did something wrong. What should I call this here? Total investing activities, you like that? Okay. And then what do we call the one under financing? How about total financing activities? You put activities if you want. Total operating activities, total financing, investing activities rather, and total financing activities. And we're done. That's everything. Okay, yes, sir.
How come current liability is 39 and not 42?
Oh, it's not current liabilities, that's everything.
Everything.
That's 63 plus 45 less 6 plus 4 less 70 less 48 plus 9 plus 50 less 8. It's all of them. I screwed you up by putting that subtotal there. By the way, some people do put a subtotal there and get that first and then go on down. It doesn't matter, obviously. Yep. We're leaving early. Don't call my boss, David Collins, or the dean and complain. Single problem for three tests and every single problem quizzes,
then you're
in pretty good shape.
Okay.
But what I would do then too for terminology and stuff, I would actually flip through the chapter and every word that is in today's, you know, colored word, your bold, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just look at it.
Okay.
And if you know what it means, keep going.
Okay.
If you don't, read around it.
Okay.
But you do.
Okay.
That would really work.
Okay.
And you can always find more problems, but I bet
right.
You'll burn out about the time you do all the quizzes and
okay.
Tests. And the practice quizzes and tests too, of course.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
right.
Sure.
Thank you.
I'm not going to be here Monday for long. So I guess I'll leave the quiz at
home. Yeah, no, that's fine. It's no big deal.
Okay.
You got to drop one anyway. You can do it.
Fine. All right.
Just
thank
keep
you.
Working. Just keep working. I can't believe an athlete would actually skip my final test. Somebody wants to do their final, which is fire.
Okay.
The study date of 27.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, just for a coach. That's when he wants all his athletes.
Like, couldn't do that?
No. She can't either. She can take it incomplete if she wants. But I suggested that. And the reason she can't do it is because it'll affect her grade dramatically. Horrible. Take away when you study, are you kidding me? That's why you can't do it too. You care what your grade is in here. Neighbors and A minus matters.
I feel like
when you're talking to PQI and Pricewaterhouse, they're gonna make fun of you if you got a B plus.
I'm just saying, like, if we review for like.
Plus, it'll affect your GPA and might not get interviews. Don't do that.
But I'm just saying, like, if we review for like those 3 days, then I could just like take it this.
Well, you can take it. I gave you a number of days you could take it. I don't want you to take it Friday. Certainly not Thursday. I don't want you to take it Friday of finals week. Although my audit class is different, but I don't want you to do that. But I don't care. What do I have? Monday and Wednesday both, if there's something on there. I got a couple different ones. Whatever my, one of them was a principal's one, and one of them was main or media one. Two were principals, and one was if you need to be successful. We're doing four classes this semester.
Hey Keith, is it bad if I take a semester in between this and 102?
I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't like that. What's your major business?
Business and econ.
And econ. I wouldn't do that if I could avoid it. It's not the end of the world. But you'll be annoyed a little. You know, when you start back, no, I didn't stop recording today. You'll be annoyed if you do that.